Good evening, everyone. Billy Oliveri with Seneca Capital Management. It is Sunday, August 22nd at 7 o'clock p.m. And I wanted to do a quick recap of the market and just share with you a few things and how I think they're going to play out. Let's click the share button. This will just be about a 4 or 5 minute video. So the first chart I want to show you is the S&P 500. At the beginning of this year, January 1st, the S&P started out the year at 3738. Today is at 4433 for a rally of about 18%. Now, mind you, that's more than double what the average return is after a new presidential election happens. The first year, whether it's Democrat or Republican, it doesn't really matter. Typically, the market will rally about 8% in this type of time frame historically. So the market has had a very, very good rally, right, as measured by the S&P 500. But one thing I do want to share with you is this chart. This chart represents the 40 sectors that make up the S&P 500. So in other words, if you were to take the S&P 500 and pluck out every single stock and put it into one of 40 bins, each bin representing what type of sector it represents, this is how it would look. Restaurants, leisure, housing, oil service companies, biotechs, precious metals, savings and loans. You can see that the entire S&P 500 is represented by 40 broad sectors. So this is the way the market looked on January 1st of this year. Lots of green, lots of favored sectors. Green is good, red is bad, yellow is average. So here you can see at the beginning of the year, the market started out with a lot of green, a lot of positive sectors. But what we see here is this incredible erosion, this huge flipping from green to red. Instead of having roughly 27 favored sectors, we only have two today. When we only had 5 negative sectors, now we have 33 negative sectors. And before we had 8 average, today we have 5. So here's an Excel spreadsheet basically showing you the same thing. Blue represents January 1st of this year, of 2021. So what we've done so far this year in 2021 is we've gone from 67.5% favored sectors to only 5% favored sectors. In terms of the average sectors, we've gone from 20% down to about 12.5%, but the unfavored sectors has gone from 12.5% last year, only 12.5 were unfavored, to 82.5% unfavored sectors. This is a horrible divergence. I don't think I've ever seen such a divergence in my entire career as an investment advisor and a floor trader. And so I wanted to share that with you because this is what it reminds me of. It does remind me of 1999 again. This is a picture of an iceberg. They say that only about 10 or 20% of the iceberg you see above the surface of the water. The rest of it, the dangerous part, is below the surface of the water. And I think that's what's happening, is we're being lulled into sleep. We're being lulled into complacency by saying, hey, the market's new, by measured by the S&P, is making new highs. When in fact, 82.5% of these companies are not doing good. I find that very, very, very interesting. And this is something we have to be careful. This is one of the reasons why I've been selling stocks along the way. This is one of the reasons why I've held on to cash, for this exact same reason. The last time this happened, the market sold off almost 50%. When it happened in 1999 to 2003, the NASDAQ fell roughly 72%, I think, from peak to trough. Now, I don't think it's going to be that bad. We have a lot of support underneath the market. And while I do believe we are in bubble status, we do have to be very, very careful, but I can't sell everything just yet. Any cash that we have, we've been hanging on to because I think it's the prudent thing to do. I believe we're going to get a ridiculously awesome, profitable, and prosperous buy signal in the next few months. So we need to see this decline. We need to see the pin pop the bubble. When the market declines, it's frankly not going to be as bad as everybody is saying. It's not going to be as bad as the media will portray, because again, we have a lot of support and some very positive things about the market that I'll get to in another letter. But again, I just wanted to share with you what's going on. If you have any questions about your portfolio, don't hesitate to ask and give us a call or send us an email. Again, this is Bill Oliveri, August 22nd, with the quick tone of the market, and we'll see you later. Thank you.